Live from Oakland, California, the Bay Area. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Baltimore Orioles going up against the Oakland Athletics. And we'll be back with the first pitch right after this. All right, first pitch coming up. Today's starting pitcher, Brent Honeywell Jr. What's the word on him?
Well, there are going to be a lot of balls in play because of the ground ball rate. Important that the defense stays engaged in the game. I think it's critical. Tempo is there. If you work quickly, it helps the fielders behind you to stay engaged, to make those plays, and help you get through the innings.
So clean just about set now. Now it's the shortstop, Ramon Urias. The wind to kick the pitch. The other way. Base hit right field.
Batting second, the second baseman, Jorge.
Jorge Mateo now.
Mateo.
The pitch. And he boots it.
He's good.
Batting third, the center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
Cedric Mullins, the next to hit for the Orioles. Looking pretty good at the plate. He's 4-for-10 in the series.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Kicks and deals. Clips the corner. One ball, one strike.
Getting a little frustrated with the strike zone.
The 1-1. And a swing and a line drive at a right field. Drops in for a hit. Couldn't run it down. Urias doesn't stop. Heads for home. Not in time. He's safe.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. Loud contact leads to the double. I mean, you could tell it had extra bases written all over it as it jumped off of his stick.
Mountcastle.
Here's Ryan Mountcastle. This is another guy capable of hitting tape measure home runs. Out to center. He scores on the sack fly. It's 2-0.
Sometimes that can be a little tough to score on. It was hit so hard that getting back to the bag to tag takes a little bit of time by the time that outfielder catches it, but a really good job of getting that run in from third.
Trey Mancini now, hitless in the series. He's 0-for-9. So RBI spot, but Chris, this is a guy that is not really swinging the bat all that well here.
In this situation, you have a real good opportunity to get swings and misses and record a strikeout. I think you attack him in this spot.
First pitch doesn't find the zone.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
Late on that fastball.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Oh, and this one gets away. Runner holds. Count goes to 2-1. Just a weak fly ball this time. Lowry makes the grab. 2 down. All right, let's take a look at the Orioles lineup now. In that cleanup spot, a key piece for this club, Ryan Mountcastle.
Well, he's an important part of this lineup for sure. I mean, there's no doubt about it, Boog. Somebody that they try to feed off of. He does a lot of things, you know, very well up there at the plate. He's got a presence about him, and you know, he's a guy that you really kind of like to watch swing the bat.
The pitch. Anthony Santander in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Yeah. Next one is off the plate. And now it's even, one and one. Mullins on third with two out. In the dirt, kicks away from the catcher. No advance, though. Two one now. Gets under it and pops it up. Noisy under it. And that is that. Bottom half of inning number one coming up. It's the Orioles 2 and the Athletics coming to bat. And on the hill in this one, Bruce Zimmerman. Not the best results a year ago, looking for better this season, Chris.
Yeah, and I think this guy understands that if he doesn't make quicker adjustments and show improvement, that the patience that his manager has will not last as long as it did last year. So we'll see if he can get off to a great start. Perhaps the work that he did in the offseason will show good results early on. But he's got to get out of the gates going strong, or else he may find himself in the bullpen or back in the minor leagues.
Elvis Andrus leading off here as he looks at that one outside the zone. In the air, right field. Santander racing over to make the catch. And time now to check out the A's lineup. And no doubt a big factor in this series so far, Elvis Andrus.
Well, he's been incredible recently, Boog. Last month, his on-base percentage is over 500. It's just ridiculous, man. I don't think my on-base percentage was ever 500 in a month. This guy's so disciplined as a hitter. It leads him to finding good pitches to hit, and he's got the patience to just take a walk as well.
And a pitch. There's the strike. One down, base is empty.
Ball, that's out.
And another ball. And a foul ball, third base side. Two-two. Stays alive. That to right. Santander moving under it. And there's two down.
Batting third, the second baseman, Jed.
Here's Jed Lowry. Lowry. The wind of the pitch. There's the strike. Turned on, but foul wide of third. And now one and two. And it's fouled away. Kicks and fires. That one fouled off.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
Next pitch is popped up. Whips it to Mountcastle. That ends the frame. Second inning set to go. Leading off, Austin Hayes.
Leading off for the
Orioles. Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
Austin Hayes.
The pitch. Top of the zone for a called strike. Next pitch downstairs, and it's a ball and a strike. Aside to home plate duty is Ricky Holiday.
Boog, and something I've heard players saying about Ricky's strike zone is how he will call the high strike. That could be something that's tough to deal with, especially if you've got a guy out there coming at you with high velocity.
Next offering is fouled back. And here it comes. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. And that's the first out.
Just a great slider right there. And I think the key for pitchers and what hitters don't want to see is if a pitcher misses with that pitch, that he misses off the edge of the strike zone rather than in the middle of the strike zone. And right there, excellent execution, and it finished up in a perfect spot.
Rougned Odor comes up to the plate now. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The 1-1. That one pulled foul. And a 1-2. And there's a fly ball deep right field. And that one is going to go. Rougned Odor takes him deep. His fourth home run of the season. And they add a run. It's 3-0.
Lightning fast hands to be able to hit that velocity fastball on the inside part of the plate. In my experience, when you're looking out over the plate, allowing the ball to travel, it's pure reaction to hit a pitch in that location. That's a tremendous swing.
Robinson Chirinos takes a ball here as he stands in now. The 1-0. Swings through that one.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
Ripped to third. And he's out.
The batter, the shortstop, Ramon Urias.
Here's the shortstop at the plate. Ramon Urias, 3-for-8 in the series coming in. The pitch. Good eye right there. That one drilled left field. And it one hops the wall. Urias into second, and he's got a double.
Wasting no time. He's 2-for-2 now on the night, and just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Here's a speed threat, Jorge Mateo. And a pitch. And there's a ball. And the 1-0. Just off the outside part of the plate. Popped up left side. Andrews under it. makes the play, and it's out number three. Orioles add one on a solo homer. It's now 3-0. Bottom of the second, striding to the plate now for Oakland, Seth Brown. The Athletics in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
And a pitch. Fouled off. He was late. And now the lefty. Tapped at the plate, but it's a foul ball. Next pitch misses, and the count 1-2.
That's a really good job of laying off the 0-2 high fastball. Is going to make that pitcher really have to respect this hitter, even though he's behind in the count.
Next one misses, and it's 2-2. Next one just misses. 3-2 now. The wind of the pitch. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and quickly one away in the second. Chad Pinder now.
The left fielder.
The wind of the pitch.
Pinder.
That's in there, and that's strike one. And a pitch. And there's the strike.
I understand you want to try to gauge that guy's fastball, but you also have to be aggressive and ready to hit in your zone. Now you're in a tough spot.
0-2 now. That misses the zone. Gonna count 1-2. The next offering misses. 2-2. Swing and a bouncer. Odor collects it. Throw off line. He's safe. And a nice job there to keep it from getting away.
Well, kind of the story of their season so far. Things just not clicking into place. Fundamentals on all sides of the ball are lacking, and it's tough to win games at this level if you're not playing clean baseball as a team.
Here's Stephen Piscotty. Here comes a pitch. Outside corner, there's a strike. And the 0-1. Swing and a line drive caught.
Batting seven, the third baseman, Sheldon.
Down to third baseman, Noisy. Sheldon Noisy. Sat out last night's game, but back in there today. The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Pinder off of first with two away. And that one ripped to left. And that should be extra bases. And that's going to get into the corner. Lead runner gets the stop sign at third. It's a two-out double, second and third now.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in his mechanics.
So two on with two away. Here's Stephen Vogt. And he deals. popped up to the left into foul ground, and that's the third out. A's strand a couple. They trail in this one 3-0.
Concentrating my balance, give life a better chance. I'm too involved in God, not television, according to his purpose.
Top half of the third inning, and into the box for Baltimore, Cedric Mullins.
The center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
A wide to kick the pitch. And a good eye there. That one in the dirt, and it's 2-0.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound, okay with getting deep in the count, even falling behind. Well, in this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there, on its way, gone. Cedric Mullins sends it out, his fourth home run of the season. It's 4-0.
A good hitter gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Ryan Mountcastle, the next to hit for the Orioles. Here's a guy who's been struggling so far this year. It's only late April, but still hoping he'll turn it around soon. Now the 0-1. Way out front for strike two.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
Got him looking. That's his second strikeout.
Well, I think that's a case of overthinking right there. He got three straight fastballs looking in the 0-2 count. Just to pour it back.
Mancini.
Trey Mancini, the next to hit for the Orioles. The pitch. That one ripped. He's got it. There's two away.
Now batting, right fielder, Anthony Santander.
Two outs, bases empty. Now, Anthony Santander. And a pitch. That clips a corner.
Good zip on that fastball at the bottom of the zone. If he's there all day, it's going to be a tough one for the hitters.
And he's down 0-2 as he swings through it.
More and more guys are looking to slug regardless of the count. In this situation, we'll keep a close eye on his approach.
Next offering down in the dirt. Line drive. Pache makes the catch, and that'll do it. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. It's now a 4-0 ball game. Bottom of the inning, digging in for Oakland, Jonah Bride.
The first baseman, Jonah Bride.
Zimmerman back to work. Pitches in there. It's 0-1. That one the other way. Mountcastle to first in time. One gone, bottom of the third inning.
Now batting, shortstop, Elvis Andrews.
So the lineup flips over. Here's Elvis Andrews. The pitch. And that's downed away. And a foul ball left side. Kicks and fires. Pitch misses inside. 2-1. The 2-1. Fought off foul. Next pitch has popped up. Puts it away for the out.
Up next for Oakland, the center fielder, Christian Pache.
And now the center fielder, Christian Pache. Slide to right his first time. The wind of the pitch. And first offering is fouled off.
Well, they've kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come. But you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
0-2 as he waves at that one. Swing and a slow roller. Sends it to first. That's the third out. Inning over. And the A's are gone in order. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. Start of the fourth, and now it's Austin Hayes.
Leading off for the Orioles, the left fielder, Austin Hayes.
The right-hander back to work. He swings and fouls one off.
Well, he hasn't quite settled in out there. 4 runs in 3 innings. He's going to have some quick 1-2-3 innings to pitch deep into this ballgame.
Righty delivers. And a foul ball. Righty to the plate. And that skips into dirt. And a foul ball. He stays alive. On the ground, right side. Lowry, throw over to first. And one gone in the fourth as they get the leadoff man.
Now batting, third baseman, Rougned Odor.
Rougned Odor, the next to hit for the Orioles. 5-for-6 in the series, so he's a tough out right now. The pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Swings and misses, and it's 1-1. And a count 1-2. Left-hand batter waits. And now the count is even. Next offering misses. Full count now. Ball That one hammered center field. And it's gone! He sends it out of here. His second home run of the game. It's 5-0.
Knew what pitch he wanted to hit. Spit on some other pitches in this at bat. Was very patient, and it paid off.
Robinson Chirinos now up to hit. And now here batting comes.
Catcher Robinson.
And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the righty deals. Just missed.
Clearly, he hasn't had it in this game, and looks like sooner than later, they're going to have to go to the bullpen.
The wind, the kick, the 2-0. Swing and a miss as he was out front. The Athletics have some bullpen action. Paul Blackburn, the young right-hander, up and throwing. Swing and a miss. And the count is even, 2-2. Softly hit to third. Tosses across to first. He's out.
Now batting.
So back to the top of the Orioles lineup. And the batter will be the shortstop, Ramon Urias. He's got 4 hits in the series on 9 at-bats. And a pitch. Right through there for a strike. Ripped to third and caught.
Well, he was ready to make a move. I don't know if his eyes were open when he made that catch, but it is a highlight play. Great job of ending the inning.
Going, yeah, we in go mode. Going, yeah, we in go mode. Going.
Ready to go, bottom four. And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, Jed Lowrie.
The second baseman, Jed.
The wind of the pitch. In the air on the infield. And makes the grab. And there's one away.
The batter, number 15, designated hitter, Seth Brown.
So here's Brown at the plate with 3 hits and 4 runs batted in the series. Here comes a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Pitch. And that's downstairs and outside. Just off the inside edge. Swings through that one out front that time.
2 strikes to a guy who's already 0-for-1 with the punch out. The only guy in the lineup with that strikeout. But you can't get too relaxed. You still got to make good pitches to get him out.
Pitch misses there. And that's ball 3. The punch out there. And he's down on strikes for the second time today.
Yeah, that's a tough pitch to stay on. You don't want to get beat inside. And as you see that pitch continue to run away from you, by the time it's in the catcher's mitt, you think it's a ball off the plate away.
So And now, Chad Pinder, the wind and the pitch. Gets it to first. Oakland goes quietly. Nothing doing there for the A's. It's 5-0. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth, Paul Blackburn. And we'll see how he performs in this situation with his team down big.
Blackburn. Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and he needs a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Back in Oakland, stepping in, Jorge Mateo.
Jorge Mateo.
The pitch. In the air, left field. Pinder under it. And there's one down.
Now batting, the center fielder, Cedric
Mullins. Next to hit, Cedric Mullins. And the pitch. That's in there, and that is strike one.
Filling up the strike zone hasn't been the problem so far. It's the quality of the strikes. That's been the real issue, and you look at the first inning, that's what we saw. Too many pitches out over the plate.
And there's a foul ball. And the right-hander deals. That gets down for a hit.
Clearly seeing the ball very well in this one. That's a ball that a lot of times you'll see the shortstop or left fielder be able to get to if it hangs up in the air long enough. But right there, it just died and found a way to drop in on the green stuff with base hit.
Ryan Mountcastle, the next to hit. The pitch.
Ooh.
Mullins leads off first with one away. Yeah. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, I think that pitch surprised all of us. Right down the middle, doesn't get a swing. Not very often you see a hitter lay off a cookie like that.
Blackburn with a move to first.
Runner,
here's the pitch. Runner goes. There's the ball, the tag, and he's out at second. Kicks and deals. Just missed. The 3-1. Swings through that one for strike two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Stays alive. Payoff pitch. And that's ball four.
Boog, if I were him, I'd be nibbling around the plate as well. I mean, this guy is just capable of hitting pitches outside of the zone and driving them a long way.
Mancini. Runner at first with two away. Now here's the Orioles DH, Trey Mancini. And a pitch. That's a strike. 0-1.
No base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me. And at bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Out towards center. That'll drop in. Plays it on a hop.
when you flare a ball out behind now second base, it's really a tough spot for anyone to get to. And you're never trying to do that as a hitter, but when you do, I tell you what, you're yelling at it the entire way to get down.
Anthony Santander at the plate. And he deals. And downstairs. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. The next pitch misses, and the count is 2-0. Kicks and fires. That one ripped. Brings it in for the third out. Orioles strand a couple, but they hold a 5-0 lead. Back here at the ballpark, John Chami with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom five, the right Stephen field. Piscotty.
Stephen Piscotty.
Pitch. Top of the zone for a strike. Strike one.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
Soft contact in the air. Mateo pulls it down. One away.
Now batting, the third baseman, Sheldon Noisy.
And now Sheldon Noisy doubled his first time up. The wind of the pitch. And first offering is fouled off. The wind to kick the pitch. And that one pulled foul.
Well, that ball was hit pretty hard and sure had home run distance, but if you're the pitcher out there on the mound, you execute it. Just a long strike, you go after him and finish him off.
And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Next offering is fouled back. And here it comes. Line drive, base hit.
Now back.
Only two hits allowed so far tonight, Boog. So I don't think that one will disrupt his momentum all that much. You know, he's really been on top of his game, commanding his pitches all night long.
One down, and now here's the A's catcher, Stephen Vogt. And a pitch. And strike one to the catcher.
Boog, over 80% of his first pitches are strikes. If you're doing that, you could have a really good day out there on the mound.
And now the lefty. Foul ball there. Here's the 0-2. Pitch misses. Now 1-2. One pushed foul. At the belt and fires. Stays alive. pitch. And now it's even up. Left-hand batter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Puts the squeeze on it. And there are two outs.
Now batting, first baseman, Yoda Bry. Dogs wanna
bark and hounds wanna howl. Man at first, and the batter now, Jonah Bry. And a pitch. Foul ball. Noisy off of first with two away. Next pitch misses. One and one. Here's a 1-1. Yeah, that's outside. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. Slice the other way. That's a base hit. Not in time. He's safe.
Well, the last 10 games or so have been anything but fun at the plate for him, so that one has to feel good. I'll tell you, and it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bump the other way. And you can feel this crowd waking up a bit here as the guys are starting to make some noise with their bats.
Now here is Elvis Andrus. Two outs. There's a strike. Next pitch misses way outside. Two outs, two in scoring position. Here's a 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Two on, two outs. Left field. Hayes makes the catch, and that'll do it. A's strand a couple. Still looking at that 5-0 deficit. Top six, and now it's Austin Hayes.
Leading off for the Orioles, the left fielder, Austin Hayes.
Yeah, the right-hander back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Righty to the plate. Out to short. Andrus picks it up. Andrus throws the first. And that's one out as they get the leadoff hitter in the sixth.
Now batting, the third baseman, Rougned Odor.
Rougned Odor comes up to the plate now. And the way he's going in this one, we've been waiting for his spot to come around again.
All right, listen, everyone. Stop what you're doing right now. This guy's got two home runs already. Now he's going for number three.
Wind in the pitch. There's a strike. And the righty deals. Slapped foul. The wind of the pitch. Off the mark there. Now one and two.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
Here comes a pitch. That one pushed to the left and foul. The 1-2. You know, with the shift on, hits right into it. Bryant takes it himself. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Now batting, the catcher, Robinson.
Two outs, bases empty. Robinson Chirinos, the next to hit for the Orioles. Blackburn back to work. In there at the knees. That's strike one. Next pitch is outside. Kicks and deals. Popped up right side. Bryant under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. 2-3-4 due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Orioles 5 and the A's nothing. And welcome back. Here's Christian Pache.
The Athletics. The center fielder. Christian.
The pitch. A little bit low. Called strike right there. And a pitch. Pulls that one foul. And he deals. Stays alive. Next offering misses. 2-2.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to lay off.
Out towards left center. Hayes racing over to make the catch.
Now batting second baseman,
Jed Lowry. Up next for the A's. A switch hitter batting right. Pitch. The other way, and that's just foul.
When a guy's throwing a lot of first pitch strikes as a hitter, you got to be ready to hit. Now, that's not going to help you get deep into his pitch count and into the bullpen, but you got to take what he's offering that day.
Line drive, snags it for the second out.
The batter, number 50, designated hitter.
So here's Brown at the plate. The pitch. That misses. Ball one. Movement in the Orioles bullpen. D.L. Hall, the left-hander, up and throwing. Lopez warming up as well. The lefty, the 1-0. Check swing, but he went too far. And it's 1-1. Next pitch misses inside. 2-1.
Struggled a little bit in this one. Couple of strikeouts earlier, but doing a much better job in this at bat to get ahead and find a good hitter's count at 2-0.
Rips one to right. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. That is the inning. And 1-2-3 go the A's. It's 5-0. So a new pitcher on the mound for the A's, A.J. Puck. Big deficit here, but he's still got a job to do. Welcome back, and now it's going to be Ramon Urias.
Leading off for the Orioles, the shortstop, Ramon Urias.
The pitch. Good eye right there.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
And a foul ball. And a 1-1. And fouled off. Next offering misses, 2-2. Now all even up. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Yeah, he's not going to be able to show us that bruise tomorrow.
The second baseman, Jorge Mateo.
And here comes. Mateo at the plate and takes high there. Bullpen activity starting up now. Danny Jimenez getting loose out there. Acevedo getting cranked up as well. On the ground, a short could be two. One at second. Throw to first, but he beat it.
Tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feet and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
Man at first, Cedric Mullins, the next to hit for the Orioles. And the pitch. That one called a strike. 0-1. 0-1's
the count.
Mateo runs. Pitch misses inside. In there safely.
Clearly not content with the lead they're working with right now, and I like that. I don't think you can get comfortable with a 5-run lead in today's game, and now they've got a good chance of adding on.
Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Here comes the runner. He's in there.
Well done. Drives in the run. Just one of those seen high-base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Here's Ryan Mountcastle. Move to first, and he's back in standing. Here comes a pitch. Slider misses outside. Mullins over at first with one away. Next offering is in for a strike.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
At the belt and fires.
Ball in.
just off the inside edge.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. He dives but can't make the play, and that's a foul ball. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Second walk of the game for him, and he's been really patient at the plate, a game plan that he's sticking to. He's just not going outside of what he's looking for up there.
So first and second with one man gone. And next for the Orioles, Trey Mancini. The pitch. And that's outside. And now the lefty. There's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Mullins coming home. Not in time. He's safe.
Right there, he does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Anthony Santander.
On the mound now, Domingo Acevedo. Hasn't pitched in the last 3 days.
Number 68. Domingo Acevedo.
Anthony Santander at the plate. The pitch. A little out front there as he swings through it. Plenty of offense in this one, Singy. I guess you'd say kind of what we expected, though.
Well, this was a game, looking at the pitching matchup, where you expected offense to score, and not as lopsided as this. But, yeah, you definitely expected to see some offense coming up.
Next pitch is outside, and that's ball one. Two on, one out. That one catches the corner for a strike. And a foul ball. Runners at first and second with one gone. And the right-hander deals.
We're going to count 2-2.
And that one fouled off. And now it's filled up. Left field, way back there. Knocks it down. It bangs off the wall. Pinder hurries it back in. They hold him at third base. And now the bases are loaded.
Left fielder, Austin Hayes.
And here is Austin Hayes for the fourth time tonight. And a pitch. And that's outside. Right-hander kicks, deals. And that one fouled off. And a pitch. That's inside.
Boog, in situations like these, the air can get really thin up there at the plate. Got to find a way to breathe and slow everything down.
And he swings and lifts one to deep center field. That's back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. A soaring shot to center. And they add on. It's 11-0.
Well, he comes through big time with the grand slam here, but you also got to give some credit to the guys ahead of him. Good at bats to get on base and really set the table for a very special moment in this one.
So one out, nobody on. So next to hit for Baltimore, Rougned Odor. Ripped, but it curls foul. And now the 0-1. Still only one out here in the inning. Next offering is in for a strike. Next one misses. It's 2-2.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
That one ripped. That's a hit.
Having a really nice game here. That's his second extra base hit. Warriors. Nice line drive to the pole side. Met it Robinson. Out front, but just stayed Chirino. Through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now the catcher, Robinson Chirinos. And a pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
Ball one, no strikes.
Kicks and fires. Just missed.
When the skipper calls down to the bullpen, he's expecting the guy to come in and get outs. So far, not getting what he was hoping for.
Next one is off the plate, and that's ball three. Right-handed reliever. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Four pitches. That's an easy walk, man. He could have walked me right there, Booth. The last one wasn't even close.
At the plate, Ramon Urias. Singy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots.
Just a bit tardy there. Not sure if he had a hard time picking it up out of the hand or if he was sitting off speed.
Comes up empty on the swing. 0-2 now.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
And the righty deals. Swing and a foul, pushed off to the right.
If you're a guy that can only hit to one field, then you're really not going to be able to come through in clutch situations because pitchers are going to adjust. But because he's able to use the entire field, that's why he's so successful in these situations.
That one the other way, puts it away for the out.
Now batting, second baseman, Jorge Mateo.
Jorge Mateo now. Yeah, the right-hander back to work. Way outside. And it's 1-0. Two outs. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1. Righty delivers. Odor, the lead runner at second. Chirinos at first. Two out of the inning. Next pitch inside. And the count is 3-1. Swings and misses, and we're filled up.
It might be time to choke up a little bit, get that front foot down early, maybe even just spread out. He's really late right now.
Righty to the plate. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Two on, two outs. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. Dives and makes the catch.
We refer to third base as the hot corner, but that one was a hot one on the other side of the diamond. Nice job, quickly leaving the ground, makes the catch, and that ends the inning. Let's go, baby,
let's get wild. Back here in the East Bay, set for the last half of the seventh. Chad Pinder now.
The left fielder, Chad Pinder.
The wind and the pitch. That one catches the zone. That's strike one.
I really like how he's been attacking hitters early in at bats. He's thrown strikes on the first pitch to over 70% of the guys he's faced in this one.
Whips it to Mountcastle, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
Now batting the right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
Here's Stephen Piscotty. The wide to kick the pitch. That one misses, and that's ball one. The wind of the pitch. Line drive. Pulls it down, and there's two gone.
Man, he smoked that fastball. He's all over it. It's just frustrating when you can't get it to fall. Maybe next time off, they'll find a hole.
Two outs, bases empty. Sheldon Noisy getting ready to hit. And he deals. That one is upstairs.
Ball one, no strike.
On a line, base hit. We all saw his hit hard, but how hard was it, Singy? StatCast is here with the answer.
Yeah, Boog, it says the exit velo was 113 miles per hour, and it looked every bit of it, didn't it? I mean, just an impressive swing of the bat, and clearly he saw it out of the pitcher's hand no problem.
Here's Stephen Vogt. Well struck, right field. Holy Toledo! His first homer of the year, and they inch closer. It's 11-2. This is the one. This is the one.
when you're lacking velocity, it's so critical that you move the ball around, change speeds, even try to trick the hitter at times. But when you give up a home run right there, manager doesn't have a lot of patience because the velocity's not there to overcome and get the swing and miss.
Manager out of the dugout, and he's going to make a change. Bruce Zimmerman, done for the night. And as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. They hand the ball over to a new arm, D.L. Hall. He's pitching on 2 days rest.
Well, I think that what makes him so tough against left-handers is he hides the ball for a long time. And from that same side, harder for you to determine which part of the plate it's going to end up on.
Two outs, nobody on. And now the first baseman, Jonah Bry.
The first baseman.
In there, and it's 0-1.
Bry.
The 0-1. This to third, and there's a hit. Now he'll turn for second. Puts the tag on him, leaving the box, and that's the third out. So it may be too little, too late, but they're on the board here in the late going. Eighth inning coming up. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back in Oakland for the top of the eighth, here's the center fielder, Cedric Mullins.
The center fielder,
Cedric. Bounced up the middle, sneaks through, base hit.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Just kept it simple. Played pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
Ryan Mountcastle digs in now. The right-hander back to work. And takes low for ball one. And here it comes. That one missed. Movement in the bullpen. Danny Jimenez up and loosening in the pen. Guerra getting loose as well. Mullins aboard here at first with nobody out. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. Here's the 2-2. Liner staked at first. Dives for the bag. Got him. Double play.
Now batting the designated hitter, Trey Mancini.
Two outs, base is empty. Trey Mancini now. And the pitch. Late swing, fouled off. Oh, one down. This one chopped up the middle. Tosses to first, and that'll do it. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's the Orioles 11 and the A's 2. Back here at the ballpark, now it's the shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
Leading off for the A's, the shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
The pitch. And that one just misses. A ball and no strikes. Activity in the bullpen for Baltimore. Tyler Wells getting ready to go. Scott, the power lefty, up as well. The wind of the pitch. That's off the mark, 2-0.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up, and that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
Pitch misses inside, and now 3-0. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it could be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this mound, but you've got to find a way to get ahead in the count quickly. He hasn't. We'll see how this at-bat turns out.
In for a strike, now 3-1.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
And now a full count.
3 balls, 2 strikes.
In the air, right field. Makes the grab on the run. One down.
Now batting, center fielder, Christian.
Christian Pache. Up next for the A's. The pitch. Good eye in that spot. Here comes a pitch. That one misses, and it's 2-1. Next offering is down low. Three-one, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, that's a really good take right there, and that's just mentally prepared, knowing that if it's not on a tee, you're going to take that pitch because you still have one more strike to work with. Not easy to lay off, but he did an excellent job in that plate appearance.
And he deals. Lowry swings through one there. At the belt and fires. And a swing and a miss.
Well, the hitter shows the pitcher that he's willing to go after that pitch down in the zone. So perhaps he'll come back to it. Still try to get that ground ball double play.
Kicks and deals. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
See how the catcher wanted that pitch up and in. Wanted to try to tie him up. That's the one thing we're seeing, that high fastball. You have to get it up there because of how hitters have changed their swings.
And the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Two gone now.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way.
But
that
50.
Time, a little
designated
anxious.
Hitter. Set. Brown.
Bet at first, and next will be the cleanup hitter, Seth Brown. The pitch. And ball one. Next offering is down low. 2 balls, no strikes. Left-hand batter waits. And that one is lifted in the air. Hayes settles underneath it. Makes the grab. And that is that. The A's strand one. That won't help much. It's 11-2. All set to start the ninth in this one. And into the box for Baltimore, Anthony Santander.
Anthony Santander.
And a pitch. And it's fouled away. And the 0-1.
I got to count 0 and 2.
Oh, Hard on the ground to first. Bryant steps on the bag, and the leadoff man retired here in the ninth.
The batter, the left fielder, Austin Hayes.
Here's the left fielder, Austin Hayes. He's already homered here in this one. Acevedo back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Next one is off the play. Now 2-0. He swings and hits a fly ball center field. Pache puts the squeeze on that one, and there's two away.
Up next for the Orioles, the third baseman, Rougned.
Two outs, base is empty. And next for the Orioles, Rougned Odor. The pitch. Just missed. Two balls, no strikes, the count.
Two balls, no strikes.
Left-hand hitter waits. And that one wrapped foul. Comes a 2-2. And a swing and a miss. And that's that.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field. We all have different visions of a future. What you think lie ahead
for the coming days? New leaves are on the same course. And welcome back. And now, Chad Pinder.
The left fielder, Chad.
A line and a pitch. There's the strike. Movement in the Orioles bullpen. Dylan Tate preparing to come on if needed. Scott getting cranked up as well. And a pitch. And there's a ball. And now the count 1-2 after the swing and the miss. Up the middle. Mateo sends it to first. One up, one down.
Now batting, right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
Next up for the A's, Stephen Piscotty. The pitch. And ball one to the right fielder. And that one a little bit high. Swing and a ball hammered left field. That's down. One hops off the wall.
Oh, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
Here's the third baseman, Sheldon Noisy. Pitch. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
He's been great in this one. Eye-hand coordination just failed him a little bit right there.
Back up the middle and a base hit. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Now batting, catcher.
I could watch base hits like that one all day long, and so could every hitting coach in the league. Just a nice line drive into center field.
Here's the catcher, Stephen Vogt, one for three. And a pitch. And a good eye there. Kicks and fires. And there's a rocket into the outfield. Throw back in, holds the runner at third. Base is now loaded. Only one away.
That's three singles in a row. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Now here is Jonah Bride. First offering, misses the mark.
Well, he's just given up three straight hits and now behind in this count to this hitter. Might be a good time for somebody to call a timeout. Maybe the pitching coach go out there and talk to him just a little bit.
The 1-0. And that one fouled off. Here's a 1-1. And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
And now the lefty. That one ripped. In there safely.
Now batting, the shortstop, Elvis Andrews.
Here's Elvis Andrews. And a pitch. Inside corner for a strike, strike one.
Well, a good slider from an opposite-handed pitcher has to stay in that tunnel just a little bit longer. Otherwise, recognition can cause you to barrel it up. And right there, the hitter clearly couldn't do anything with it.
In the dirt, but kept close. Nothing happening as the count evens at one. Just one out away, try to close it out.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
And that one sliced foul. First and second, two down. Next offering is downstairs. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Bo, do you think you could draw a walk in the bigs if we gave you enough at-bats?
Ooh, that's a good question.
I think that if they gave the pitcher a false scouting report on me, yes, I think I could draw a walk. And here it comes. Pache takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now. Next pitch inside and 1-1.
Ball
Next one misses, and it's 2-1. Noisy on third.
Vogt
on second. Andrews on at first with two down. On the ground, right side. And that'll do it.
That was a pretty close one until that huge seventh inning really turned things around. The bats just caught on fire, and it seemed like nobody could make it out. Put a lot of runs up, and that propelled them to the win.
And your final, 11-3, as the Orioles win this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew, I'm John Ciampi saying so long.
From the home of the solid gold, honey, and milk. The ones who built it from the mud, soil, and sand. A black man, the world in the skin of his hand. Pop Della Sock when I shine beyond Stella Fella.
Our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Orioles. 11 runs on 14 hits. One error. They left six men on base. For the Athletics, 3 runs on 9 hits. One error. They left 8 runners on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 35 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safe.